Hello and welcome back, everybody. My name is Philipp Schulz. I'm joined by Martin Wagner. Martin, how are you? Are you excited for the losers finals coming up?
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be super hype to see who will end up in the grand final, battling it out. And yeah, it's just exciting to be here. Exciting to see all the player made it. Players made it through all those games. They had such a long journey to get here, and yeah, it's just a very nice ending to top it all off.
Yeah, and it came down to what we talked about earlier. We've been saying that it's kind of a story of the best Zacian variant trying to overcome the Spiritomb. So we've been foregoing Aaron a little bit because he was the lone Pika player and there were three Zacian variants, so we were kind of like focusing on the Zacians. But Aaron put on a great fight, just barely losing out to Azul, almost made it to the losers finals and almost had a shot at fighting those Spiritombs. Now, however, it's on Azul to take it on. And so the first thing to notice when we are looking at this list is, of course, we've mentioned this earlier, but he's not playing any stadium card or any way to remove stadiums. And yeah, we've just seen how that put him in a lot of trouble dealing with Aaron's Wondrous Labyrinth. And yeah, he might run into the same issue again as he's trying to overcome Kevin. Because Kevin, of course, has this Black Market Prism Star in his deck, and if Azul is not able to remove it, he might well not be able to keep up in the price trade and just get overwhelmed.
Yeah, it's going to be super annoying to deal with it. Azul has some gust effects to gust around the spirit tombs and stuff, but it's certainly going to be super tough. But I don't think we want to prolong that any further. I think the hype has been built up. It's everyone is super ready, and yeah, we don't want to keep the players waiting any longer. So I think we're ready to go into the game.
Yep, and yeah, just starting up, adding each other.
Yes,
starting to get into the game, and yeah, we've seen Kevin's list already earlier. Functioned pretty well, and it's a surprising deck of tournament, and we will see how impactful that Black Market will be helping him against this traditionally pretty hard matchup of Zacian in general. Azul also is not running any Metal Frying Pan, so let's not forget this makes it much easier for Spiritomb to get the knockouts, actually. It makes it even possible. I mean, Kevin does have a tool scrapper would have had a tool scrapper in case, but he would have had to find this, and once that tool scrapper would have gone, Zacians with Metal Frying Pan would have been super safe. But yeah, Azul not playing with Metal Frying Pan seemed to have been impactful in all the games, in most of the games so far at least, but Azul came out on top nonetheless, so maybe that 30 damage making it a little harder for your opponent is just not necessary. And yeah, if Azul just manages to keep running well, he's just gonna take it that way.
Yeah, Azul is going first here. He has a good start. He has the Zacian being grabbed by the quick ball, starting Jirachi as well. So he's well set up, but yeah, in general, I would think that Kevin is really favored in this matchup. Of course, not only because of the nature of the price trades, but as you mentioned, Black Market Prism Star coming in very handy. So let's see if Azul can overcome this last big roadblock, I would say, towards the move towards the grand finals.
And yeah, if he manages to do so, he would have to face pretty much the exact same roadblock once again. So this might be very well an indicator of who's gonna win the tournament. I mean, of course, if Kevin is winning this, then we know that Spiritomb will be winning the game. So this is the first chance for Spiritomb to claim a victory, and it's Kevin's chance to get back to Luke and get, yeah, revenge, basically. And yeah, Azul already had a pretty strong start, however, with the Zacian.
Yeah, really nice.
Yeah, and on the other side, Kevin's hand is not looking too amazing.
Yeah, just forced to go for research, try to go again, get some more Pokemon out. There's the Black Market already, so that's probably gonna hit the board early, since Kevin knows that Azul is not playing any counter stadiums, but Kevin needs to find Spiritombs pretty soon.
Yeah, other than that Black Market, his hand's looking very meager. He has a Jirachi at least, so he's not gonna get benched anytime soon. And he's gonna have some more consistency, but this is a really slow start. Not seeing any Spiritomb on the first turn and not getting Jirachi into the active to start setting up yourself is not what you're looking for.
Yeah, just forced to pass it over. And Elfie Azul, you really like to see that Nosferatu hitting the bot just yet. And Azul will probably be ready to start swinging with the Brave Blade and trying to take some early knockouts, take some early advantage, maybe even look for a combo. There's a quick ball in his hand, and yeah, if he gets like another quick ball off the Stellar Wish, he could try to go for a combo right here, but just missing the energy, I think.
Yeah, exactly. Fortunately for Kevin, he is missing the energy, and so otherwise he could have also just boss ordered up the Jirachi and tried to exploit Kevin's slow start even further and set him back, weaken his board.
Yeah, taking out the
Yeah.
Jirachis versus Spiritomb is just super valuable because they are so reliant on that back-to-back-to-back Stellar Wish. So Azul getting a Professor's Research as the draw supporter, saving the boss for the following turns. I think these are going to be super crucial. You want those to gust around the Spiritombs that have the energies attached to them,
Yeah.
so you can actually take some knockouts.
Or you just want to gust up the Spiritombs before they have energies, and while you can still take prizes on them. Also, by that way, preventing them to build up a lot of spites.
Yes, that way you don't have to fear a lot. So quick ball also coming down, continuing to set up the board most likely. Yeah, stuff like there's a Zamazenta, so that could be useful in the matchup. Scoop up net coming up, removing the Jirachi from play. Oranguru going back to the active. So yeah, once again, still access to another Stellar Wish. This time combined with the escape pod as well. So really good start from Azul here, trying to combo off really and yeah, build a huge board.
Yeah, however, still not finding an energy. Oh, actually, no, where's the energy? Okay, and the Brave Blade knockout. So, solid start. Also getting the Zamazenta down, which is a pretty decent attacker in this matchup because it has those 10 more HP than Zacian V. So it doesn't get one shot. It gets one shot a little bit harder, of course. There's Alolan Zigzag, a Galarian Zigzagoon in Kevin's list. So he can still reach those 230, but he's gonna need a full Spirit Omp with 5 damage counters, Hustle Belt, and Alolan Zigzagoon. And now he's finally finding his first Spirit Omp. Also, Jirachi in the active definitely helps him.
Yeah, going to be able to start building up some spite. Yeah, once Spiritomb gets rolling, it's really yeah, it's just a question of when you can start swinging back to back to back with Spiritomb. But till you get there, you probably ju yeah, you just sit back. You don't have that great early attackers. That's why I like the Cryogonal inclusion that Luke has made quite a bit, because it can stall out in scenarios like this. But here, yeah, Kevin deciding to not play that, instead a bit more of a streamlined approach. Yeah, going for Spiritomb here and will start building up some spite. But other than that, there we won't be seeing a lot more on this turn. Of course, if the Spiritomb, if you attach the energy here, if it were to be knocked out, then Azul won't take any prize cards. So there's not really a point of it gusting it up, so the Spiritomb on the bench is protected and the damage on it is pretty safe on there too.
Yeah, the money coming down, disrupting Azul a little bit. Going for the rainbow for Kevin and also using building spite immediately is an interesting choice. Would have been maybe a useful play to maybe go for 40 damage just with an Anguish Cry to set up a Zacian for a knockoff with Yveltal later on or weaken it up a bit. But Kevin not drawing an escape pod or switching card, so just passes the turn and saving his Spirit Hump on the bench.
Yeah, let's see what yeah, Azul's hand is also not looking great. He might be forced to even retreat the Zacian for 2 energy, which hurts every time you do it. He did get manied into a hand without any draw supporters, so he has the Mr. Mime Jirachi Prism Star combo, so in the late game it will be very helpful, and that is a great Primal Wisdom if I have ever seen one.
Yeah, for sure. That was a good trade. Getting the Dedenne and putting the Jirachi into the prizes. So, pretty strong draw for Azul. And yeah, he really needs to continue the pressure once he... Oh, actually, yeah, the Girati Prism, interestingly, the Girati Prism does much worse versus Spiritomb Black Market than ADP would be. Because with ADP you would still take one prize, but with Girati you first need to take a prize, so you can take the Girati and activate it. So
yeah, you actually have to knock out something and then take the...
Yeah, exactly. You have to take the prize.
Yeah.
And if the first prize is denied, then you also don't get a second one. So if Kevin manages to set up a bot with just Spiritombs, and that have energies, Azul won't have any way to take any more prizes, and at that point he'd just have to hope that Kevin runs out of Pokemon. Yeah, which is not the greatest win condition for a deck like Spiritomb that's kind of supposed to get out a lot of one prize attackers and don't run out of prizes.
Yeah, Azul already down two switches, so the mobility is certainly a factor that you always have to keep in mind when playing Zacian, so you can swing continuously. So two switches being
and
down
shout
already.
Out to Make Love No War Turtle for the 2,222 bits. Thanks a lot once again for a big contribution, and thanks for showing continuous support for our for this project. And I hope you're enjoying the losers finals right now. Yeah, Azul is trying to overwhelm Kevin. And yeah, Kevin looking to find footing. And yeah, Azul now almost powering up with Zamazenta. Yeah, getting an energy there, having a Saucer in the backhand. So he's pretty much, he's decently prepared to keep attacking. I don't think he has metal energies in his discard pile right now, so he can't power up for Zamazenta yet. So he will need he doesn't have a guaranteed attack for next turn yet.
That's the nice thing about Zamazenta is that the attack doesn't come with like the drawback, you can't attack next turn. So Zamazenta can actually attack back to back without requiring any resource investment, and both Zacian and Zamazenta both knock out Spiritomb and probably all the Pokemon that Kevin will ever put up in one hit anyway. So the Zamazenta is a nice attacker that you don't need to really invest a lot of resources in.
Yeah, and usually of course it would be even more useful since it can discuss a special energy, so it would usually forego Black Market, but there seems to be a PTCGO bug that prevents this interaction, and we weren't aware of this earlier, otherwise we might have decided to ban Black Market.
But Kevin is playing around it anyway, right? He's
exactly.
He's playing it as if like the card would work properly by attaching the second darkness energy. So even if Zamazenta would discard before knocking out the Pokemon, then there would still be a rainbow energy attached to the Spiritomb, and the Black Market Prism Star would still is still activated and working and would deny the prize from Azul.
In this scenario, of course, the second rainbow coming down just to accelerate the damage on the Spiritomb, and now with the Hustle Band, it will be able to take a knockout on the Zacian and finally put on put some pressure back on Azul after Kevin wasn't able to stabilize early on. But even if he now got a knockout, his board is still very weak. He doesn't have
no damage on board to move around, right? And
already three rainbows gone.
Oof, that's a lot of your damage acceleration comes from that attaching that rainbow energy from turn after turn. And now there are metal energies in the discard pile for Azul. He can promote the Jirachi and Saucer to whatever he wants to, and it looks like he's going to attach to a Jirachi and setting up towards a slap.
Yeah. Somewhat interesting that he's opting to go for Jirachi and for Zamazenta right away, since I think later on it will be likelier for Kevin to get the knockout on the Zamazenta, while right now he wouldn't be able to get a one-shot at all, and he can relatively easily get the one-shot on the Jirachi. But Azul just valuing this continuous attacking, making sure to build up multiple attackers.
Also, it's offering up a non-priced attacker, so you don't really lose anything. So if you offer up the Zamazenta right here, then your opponent would need to take three times. They would need to knock out two priced Pokemon.
Yeah,
and this way, the Jirachi doesn't really lose you a whole bunch.
Yep, exactly.
That's a good top deck, by the way.
Yeah,
the research.
That's a pretty decent hand for Kevin, having the fishing rod to get a back a spirit home and a hustle belt, very important cards in this matchup, and then having the Aurora energy already to discard that useless shrine, getting scoop up net to either discard Mewtwo or maybe guarantee himself a supporter for next turn, probably depending on how many supporters he has already used. With two research and one money left, yeah, he might probably want to reuse for Mewtwo.
Just putting another research on top, so you can guarantee that you can draw through your whole deck on the following turns, get towards
And
stuff like,
finally some spirit charms.
yes,
There we
finally
go.
building some spite on the board. We'll get some mobility of the damage counters from the ominous posture from the Jinx, and that will be will allow Kevin to accelerate and try to win the prize trade from here on out.
Yeah.
See,
And
taking the knockout, of course, right here on the Jirachi. It feels kind of bad. You usually you'd like to like bosses order around stuff like this, but sometimes you just can't afford to, so you're
yeah,
forced to take the knockout.
I think taking the knockout here is totally fine. It's not really Kevin's priority to win as fast as possible on prizes, I think. Just getting through Azul's attackers should probably be fine as well. And now finding the fourth Spirit Home as well, also big find. Finally being able to get down the entire squad and be ready to charge up that much damage is so important, just so he can guarantee get himself this two shot on the Zamazenta next.
Yeah, debating whether to use the scoop up net. You could use it to almost even try going f to save another supporter. And I would assume that he would like it maybe reuse the Jinx to move some damage around,
Yeah,
prepare another Spirit Tomb.
I would have guessed just use another building spite from the Spirit Home that has already used it. But also using this Mewtwo this turn seems especially weird, since now he's gonna redraw the research, so he will probably money and put the researchers back on the bottom of the deck, so I don't quite understand why he used it right now and didn't keep it. Maybe he's just preparing against money. That's probably it. So that he doesn't get money into a useless hand, which could well happen considering that yeah, he has already used a couple of supporters, he has some in his hand, and he still has quite a high amount of deck cards, so yeah, probably just preparing for that. Yeah, and now the Azul going in with the Zamazenta.
Zamazenta's ready right now, and yeah, he's pretty safe from a one shot. Kevin would need a lot, and yeah, there we see Assault Tackle coming out. Unfortunately, not discarding the energy before the knockout.
Yeah, so unfortunate bug, as we mentioned. Not something we were aware of earlier on, so nothing we could do about it. And Azul will just have to find a way to deal with it nonetheless. So,
Yeah, we s
yeah, and thanks to that, the black market putting in work and denying two prizes in a row, and Kevin's now, thanks to that, he's now ahead in the prize trade by quite a decent margin.
Yeah, quick ball. Searching out the Giratina, probably to discard it. Thinning out the deck, you know. Now he has to. Yeah, now the research gets thrown away anyway, that he just put back on top with the Mewtwo the last turn. But he draws a whole bunch of life cards, so certainly a lot of stuff to work with. The Zigzagoon is here. Scoop Up Net is here to maybe reuse the Jinx. Even a Rainbow Energy being drawn, so there's a lot of potential for a huge Anguish Cry this turn.
Yeah, basically just missing the hustle belt, otherwise he could have just gotten the one-shot knockout
Yeah,
by using Jinx twice.
that would have been the five damage counters that are necessary, but now he's just going to have to settle for a two shot, which is fine, since your opponent doesn't take any prizes right now, if you keep the Spirit Tomb active, but settling for a two shot is fine. You drain your opponent also out of resources as well, if you just knock out all the attackers as you said earlier.
Yeah, and Kevin, however, is also running relatively low on energy, so he's only playing 9 in total with 4 rainbow energies gone. And another problem of Spirit Tomb can be running out of energies or just whiffing energies. And the biggest problem is finding your Spirit Tombs in time. Like we saw Kevin stumble with that earlier, and the black market having to make up for it. Doing that quite well, however. So yeah, the black market compensating for the issue of finding Spirit Tombs in time and getting going. But yeah, now the second issue of finding a sufficient amount of energies might come in. He still has a couple of Aurora. I think he still has mostly the unit energies. I think Kevin was the one playing four units, four
yeah.
Rainbow and one Aurora.
Definitely running out of rainbow energies, but some other energies should be still be available. But of course, you lose that valuable placement of a damage counter by not having access to rainbow energies. Yeah, there we go. Another Zacian is going to be built up in the back by Azul. He gets the second metal source of the Acrobike, so another Zacian will be ready on the following turn, where if that's necessary. And yeah, back-to-back knockouts or like back-to-back attacks are definitely secured. So that's the first step.
Yeah, and the black market bug coming in really big, since Azul by now would have won the game if it wasn't for that, since he
yes.
knocked out. Actually, he would have been at one prize, I think, if he didn't get the combo, because one of the knockouts was with Jirachi, so he would only have taken two prizes with Zamazenta, and then at least one with Jirachi Prism Star.
Yeah,
we know is in his prizes, but yeah.
Yeah, he could have comboed off another time using the double scoop up net, I think. But yeah, really unfortunate.
And yeah, however, Kevin is down to his last two Spirit Tombs. And yeah, he will use one to take a knockout on the Zamazenta. But if he can't get the one shot on, if he can't get a knockout on the Deden on the following turn, then that might be the game. And now the Adventure Bag is a pretty big find, since
yes.
it gives him access to the Hustle Belt, so that his Spirit Tomb can take the one shot here. So that's really important.
Hustle Belt plus energy, really important hit right here.
Yeah,
allowing for him to, yeah, pretty much pull super far ahead, and the price rate going down to only one price card remaining, so only one
exactly.
boss.
There's only one Hustle Belt left in the deck, however, so I don't think that Kevin will be able to close out this game. I don't think he has any attackers left. He's gonna use that one Spirit Tomb to take a knockout on the Zamazenta, but then it's gonna get knocked out by Zacian, and afterwards he only has one Spirit Tomb, and yeah, he doesn't have any Hustle Belts anymore, so
he would like need to top deck an energy, and then he could boss his order and get knockout on a Jirachi or something.
Oh yeah, true, he can still one shot Jirachi. Yeah. He just can't do it with just can't money into an energy.
Yeah, he needs to boss order. I don't think he's playing stuff like Great Catcher, so, or maybe he is playing Great Catcher, so
yeah, he is playing Great Catcher, and it's definitely still in his deck. He just moneyed it to the bottom.
Yeah.
But with the Adventure Bag, of course, he's shuffled his deck, so it's somewhere in his deck.
Yeah, so
but
also
yeah.
the Jirachi and the Switch, good pickups of the prizes. If his hand doesn't get disrupted right here, he will be able to switch into Jirachi, attach a skateboard, and then play his supporter for turn, so we'll
yeah.
maximize the odds. But I think
yeah, but he needs boss's order and and the energy next turn, because otherwise Azul will probably be able to just boss's order up the Spirit Tomb, and that point Kevin would be out of Pokemon to attack with. He's only playing for Spirit Tomb, the Buzzwole, and the Yveltal as attackers, and yeah, basically all of it is gone. But ooh, the money from Azul, giving Kevin the perfect hand, and yeah, once again, money doing the opposite of what it's supposed to do instead of disrupting him.
Just
yeah.
helps your opponent out a little bit, you know. Here, have some cards that you actually want.
Yeah, yeah. His hand, he would have actually had to top deck the energy, but now he got energy boss's order. And that will be the game. Kevin Krueger's gonna just take a knockout on Jirachi and move up 1-0 in this series, thanks to his black market Prism Star denying so many prizes from Azul.
Yeah, there we go. English cry for the game.
Yeah, actually, if Azul didn't get the combo twice, then he would have won even without the black market. So, yeah, definitely helped, but it wasn't necessarily the deciding factor. It would have still depended on Azul getting the combo twice or not, which is not always easy to do. But yeah, Kevin Kruger moving up 1-0, and this game pretty much went pretty well for Azul. So Azul got a strong start while Kevin was stumbling a lot. So that's really a testimony to how strong the Spirit Tomb deck is.
Yeah, I guess the game plan for game two is like, you hope your opponent doesn't draw the black market super early, I guess. I guess you hope you get to, you hope to get some free knockouts, get some early knockouts, maybe combo off once before your opponent finds that black market, and then you can maybe gust around for the last remaining prizes. Maybe Kevin starts with like an Oro Choreo or the Dene this time. That would certainly be something that Azul would have been looking for, but not a lot that is in Azul's control right now that he can do. He played it pretty much, he played it really well. He had a super good setup, he had a super nice start, so.
Yeah, it will be really hard for him to adapt. I think at one point attacking with the Jirachi, he could have attacked with Zamazenta and then switched into Jirachi just to, he would have still forced Kevin to take a knockout on a one prizer, but in that turn it might have been harder to two-shot for Zamazenta, because that turn he could only reach 70 and couldn't do more damage than that.
I mean, the Zamazenta got two-shot anyway, so
yeah, but like it could have made the two-shot harder. If a Zamazenta would have only gotten 70, then later on it would have still needed 160, but it probably didn't matter since Kevin still had that hustle band in the end. So he still had one damage modifier left to boost the damage. Yeah, so it ended up not really mattering.
Yeah, let's see who goes first. It looks like Azul is going first this time. So once again, so hopefully he starts, you know, Zacian, Jirachi, Oranguru, all the good stuff you want to see. But that is not looking like it right here. But Kevin instead has a really strong start.
For sure. That's an amazing hand, pretty much. With the Dene, of course, not great, since that's not only an easy two prizes, but you can also combo it to draw even more prizes. So, yeah, no supporter yet for Kevin is not amazing. But he can still find something with the Stellar Wish, and he has great other cards. Even if he doesn't use the Dene, he might still wait a turn or maybe use another Stellar Wish. Meanwhile, Azul not finding a Zacian yet is really painful.
Yeah, the funny thing about this is like he did the combo, right? He put something into his prize cards, but it wasn't a Jirachi Prism Star. But Kevin doesn't know that, so that's like kind of a mind game that you can maybe play. Or yeah, that's just maybe interesting to note, right? The Jirachi isn't actually the prizes, even though it would look like it for Kevin. So just attach on the Mr. Mime and pass over. No Zacian to be found.
Yeah.
Going really first, once again, not working out for Zacian.
Yeah, this going first, I'm not really sure if I like the rule. It makes it more balanced for sure, since sometimes going first or going second is better or worse, but it's also like super random. So at least in the best of three, you knew you would get an advantage in game two, and now you don't really know, since you get to choose, but it's kind of random which one.
Yeah, it all
better.
Depends on your opening hand anyway,
yeah.
Right? You see your opening hand, you'd be like, yeah, if I went first or second, would have been the same, or yeah, if I went second, that would have been broken or would have been actually playable. So yeah, it's makes the game a little bit more random. I would agree with you on that for sure.
Yeah, and now Kevin using a quick ball right away. Now it will be interesting what he picks. Could have maybe gone for Stellar Wish first and then a quick ball for another Jirachi if he really just to find maybe another supporter so he can fork over the Dene. But it seems like he's just valuing going for the Spirit Tomb, and he can just use the Dene. It's probably not that terrible for him in this matchup.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of.
It can definitely backfire, because right now there's already four prizes on the board. So if Azul is just able to combo twice, he might just win the game that way.
Yeah, you love to see it when your opponent puts down the Dene, but yeah, sometimes it's just better to have a little bit more of an explosive turn, and I think here it will pay off, since Kevin is now also able to maybe Stella wish into a supporter too and try to extend even further here.
Yeah, and even without the supporter, he already has an amazing hand and an amazing board. He has his free spirit tomb and he has an energy already, so he has a really, really strong start. And yeah, so going for the aggressive play and...
Certainly working out, right? If you can snowball that advantage, it's worth for sure.
And the decision makes sense when you consider that Azul had a rather bad start, so he's trying to go aggressive and just overwhelming him, which makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, let's see. He's really debating whether he wants to go for an aggressive boss's order on the Oranguru, but just deciding to settle for the hustle belt, getting that piece for later, and saving it. And also, moving some damage around and using the Zigzagoon here, so he gets the knockout actually.
Yeah. However, that weakens his board even further. Now he has with the Danne and the Zigzagoon as kind of useless bench sitters, and the Zigzagoon could have been a Spirit Tomb otherwise. But yeah, again, if he goes for the aggressive plays, he might as well go all the way, and he plays lots of scoop up nets, so that Zigzagoon is by no means useless.
Yeah, it should be easy for him to clean up that bench spot, reuse the Zigzagoon. He got the research of the prize, but gets moneyed anyway. So he goes again. He gets a switch, so and some energy cards. So exactly what you want to see. And Azul is he drew Jirachi, he drew the Danne, but same goes for Azul, right? You never want to bench the Danne unless it gives you like an immediate advantage. But of course, sometimes you have to because it allows you to play the game.
Yeah, in this case, he doesn't really have any choice.
Yeah,
if he wolf sensation for two turns in a row, then that's gonna be terrible, and he doesn't draw an energy, which is already not great at all. Now, he does have a quick ball, but not getting to attach to the Zacian that he now finds sets him back so much. Yeah,
missing that attachment always hurts so much. Finally, Zacian coming down, and Stella Wish being available, but Kevin is already in the lead, and he will probably continue to dictate the pace of the game, and it's only a question of time when Kevin will find the Black Market Prism Star, and then the game is going to be super tough for Azul.
Yeah, at least for Metal Saucer, attaching an energy to the Zacian, two energies with a double Metal Saucer, the Interpret Sword also finding another energy. So, that whiffed energy, not too bad, the Interpret Sword making up for it and preparing that Zacian for the next turn. Really what Azul needed to have a shot in this game.
Yes.
Yeah.
Switch into Jirachi. Now there are four prizes on Azul's board, right? The Danne and the Zacian. So no real possibility for him to stagger the prizes. Kevin will probably knock out the active Jirachi here, and then look for a continue either boss's order with the five damage counters on the Spirit Tomb plus a Hustle Belt, or a great catcher, and then boss sorta after that to close out the game within the next three attacks.
Yeah, and he's certainly sitting in the driver's seat, especially if he manages to find a scoop up net here. The Black Market helps as well, of course, giving him even more time. A scoop up net would have been nice since he has a quick boss, so he could have prepared even more Spirit Tombs. But he only needs the two damage counters on the one Spirit Tomb, and the other one already is at three. So he's still fine. As long as he finds a Hustle Belt next turn, he will be able to take a knockout on the Zacian, which is really strong and would put him four prizes ahead, which would be incredibly hard to come back for Azul.
Yeah. Also, the Danne be on board meaning exactly. Being on board. It's like you can chill with the gusting of the Zacian, even if it wouldn't like hit the active this turn, then you can just gust up the Danne and take the easy knockout there, and then take the knockout on the Zacian on the following turn. That means you get one more turn of being able to play stuff like research to dig through your deck further.
Also being this far ahead this time for Kevin means that even if he doesn't get Spirit Tombs to take a knockout on the Deden, as long as he gets the knockout on the Zacian on the next turn, he can then just sacrifice a few of his Pokemon and prepare for a Sledgehammer to take a knockout on the Deden. So he will have even more options and an even easier way to take his final prizes.
Sledgehammer taking knockouts on the Deden, it just feels so great. That really like gives you the feeling of the card, the inclusion of the card paying off and being worth in the variant.
And yeah, Azul's hand not looking good at all. His board also not amazing. He has an energy, so he can charge up, start charging up his Avasation. But oh, instead he's just opting to go for the Avasation. Not willing to take the risk here and just goes for Intrepid Sword.
Yeah, he has no cards in hand, and exactly. That's never a position where you want to leave. But that means that Kevin's damage gets to stay in play. The 20 damage on the active Spiritomb gets to stay in play. And I think that's always super huge. And there's a top deck boss's order as well. So that could spell the end of the game very quickly if you are able to knock out the Zacian with the two energies right here. That would be crazy good. If you like hit the Hustle Belt right here, then you're building Spite, you move the damage over and bosses order up.
Now Kevin eyeing up with Spirit Tomb for a second, but definitely not the right choice here. Since he does have another Spirit Tomb in his hand and his only supporter left after this turn will be a Professor's Research. So yeah, definitely doesn't want to go for this. And now even if he doesn't get a Hustle Belt of this Jirachi, a Scoop Up Net would be great as well. Since he can just pick up the Zigzagoon, put down the other Spirit Tomb instead and just take the knockout on the Deden instead of the Zacian. Still a great position for Kevin.
Now the debate is like whether you want to boss's order and take the Deden and then not really advance your hand any further, or you go Professor's Research and you hope to draw the great catcher. But yeah, I think boss's order is like safer. But
yeah, exactly. I think the boss's order makes total sense. Okay. Since he can't really advance his board further. He can. The only thing he can really find is Hustle Belt, but he already used Building Spite. He already has his bench full with Spirit Tombs. He already has energy. So he hardly needs anything, and just taking the knockout on the Deden, is amazing and puts him into a great position. And Azul realizing the writing on the wall and just opts to concede the game, not even try anymore. I mean, being four prizes behind your opponent, having three Spirit Tomb on board, having a huge hand while Azul has hardly anything at all.
No real way for Azul to come back here, and totally understandable to hit the concede button right there. A little bit unfortunate, of course, with the bug. Mattered a little bit in the first game, but not ended up mattering at all in the second game.
It wasn't necessarily game deciding in the first one. It depended on Azul's hand. I didn't keep perfect track to know if he would have been able to combo. And of course, if he's able to combo or not, also depends on the prizes that he would have gotten. So that changes a little bit. So it's hard to tell, but it could have definitely mattered, and it would have definitely given Azul a much easier way in game one, which he almost won anyway, because Kevin was almost
putting up a great fight. You know, Azul playing clean as always, really well played. It's always a pleasure to watch him, and really good deck choice. Maybe in the end a little bit greedy without the stadiums and stuff, but really well played. But Kevin in the very end will move on and meet Luke in the grand finals.
That means that our Spiritomb decks keep continuing to dominate. We were debating if one of the four decks that were in losers could manage to overtake one of the Spiritombs that were in winners finals, but it ended up but Azul ended up coming out on top of the loser's bracket, but losing 2-0 to Kevin, and now Kevin will have his chance to get back to Luke and take a victory in the best of 5 series. So that will be very exciting. Luke will be starting 1-0, so Luke only needs to win 2 games, while Kevin needs to win 3 games. So definitely the advantage is on Luke's side, and he has already won before. But now Kevin had some time to rethink his earlier match, to consider if he wants to make any adaptations. And with such a close matchup and such similar list, everything is possible for sure. And we will hopefully have a very exciting grand finals coming up very soon. We will first go to a quick break and then we'll be back.